What's up, guys? Welcome to another Domination commentary. I like to apologize because I tried to upload this commentary before, but the commentary volume was down and the gameplay volume was like all the way maxed out, so that really ruined the purpose of having a commentary, so you couldn't hear what I was saying. So in order to make up for it, I've recorded a brand new commentary. This is a new one if you haven't noticed, and hope you guys will enjoy it. So, I said I'll be giving out tips and tricks, and I'll be doing that, but first off, I just want to clear out a couple of things, and the first thing I want to clear out is PayPal. I've set up a PayPal account. The email address is in the annotation and in the description box, so if you could just donate anything you can, I would be much appreciated. I would much appreciate it. So, another thing I also like to clear up is... me and a couple of other guys, we started a gaming channel. Now, and I know what you're thinking right now. Oh god, not another one of those shits. But it's not like every other gaming channel, because me and these guys, all our subscribers, will add up to... I think it does add up to over 20,000 subscribers. And the people that I'm working with are me, Taylor, Pyropuncher, SeaNanners, ToxicSkillz, StuntSkater, JX23, and a couple of other dudes. So we started this channel called PersonaGaming, and it's gonna be like for commentary. It's gonna be like a commentary channel. We're also gonna do top 5 plays and things like that. And we also set up a website, not one of those like .webs.com websites. It's a real .com website to show you that we're serious, and we got a guy working on it. It just started, so it doesn't look like a really expensive looking website, but in due time it will be much better. We just had to bring something out real quick, and we're gonna be working on it. We're gonna be working on new videos for it. So subscribe to the YouTube channel that we have hooked up. Link is in the annotation right at the bottom of your screen, and also in the description box, because if you click the annotation right now, it'll just take you to the channel and exit my commentary. But you never know, maybe some of you guys don't like my commentary. I don't know, why would you be watching it then? Duh. But, I'm gonna start giving out tips right now, because they could carry over to Modern Warfare 2. And the first tip that I'd like to give you guys is the most valuable thing that you could possibly learn in life is never to get angry. Do not get angry at Call of Duty 4 or anything else that you do in life. And if you happen to do get angry, just don't get angry at the fact that you got angry, because sometimes people think that when they get angry, they're weak. No, you're not weak. It's just it's human nature. When you get angry, it's human nature, but we gotta learn how to control that anger and make sure that it doesn't happen. And the reason why I say not to get angry is because when you get angry at a game like Call of Duty 4, you're gonna be going out looking for a revenge kill. For example, if a guy kills you 20 times in a match and you haven't even killed him once, you're gonna be pretty pissed off. Especially if you're having a really bad day. If you're having like a really, really, really good day, and you probably won't give a shit, but if you had a bad day, I'm pretty sure you'll be pissed off. So, when that happens, you'll be going out for what's called a revenge kill, and when going for a revenge kill, you will care about nobody else except the person that you're trying to get revenge on, meaning that everybody else on the opposite team will have a chance to get a cheap shot at you, because they'll see you running around looking for that one guy and just say, whoa, look at this guy, boom, you're dead. And there's a lot of M16 guys these days, and hopefully it won't be an M16 in Modern Warfare 2, but it's a very high possibility at this point that they're gonna put it in Modern Warfare 2. So remember not to get angry and keep your cool. I'll be giving out more shotgun tips than anything else in this right now, because I'm using a shotgun. So when using a shotgun, it's best to use a grip in any situation, any map, and any game type. Always use a grip, because the grip gives you more accuracy, and it gives you a higher possibility of hitting collaterals and triples, and luckily quads with a shotgun, which you don't come around a lot. You don't see quads a lot. So that's a tip for a shotgun. It's a very good tip. Also, keeping mobile. When you have a shotgun, keeping mobile is the best way to get more kills and more XP, and it also helps you get more better at this game. Because if you just stay in one spot waiting for somebody to pass by, you're going to start getting used to it. And you're just going to start getting used to taking people by surprise. But what you have to acquire is the skill of being able to handle a situation when somebody's about to take you by surprise. You have to learn how to surprise them back and kill them. Like at this point right there. He stunned me and he was going to come around and try to get a nice little cheap kill at me. I think he had Juggernaut, I'm not sure. Yeah, I just forgot what I just shot at right now, but I killed him and I learned how to handle a situation without taking by surprise. Another tip that is much helpful, especially with these days grenade spam and all that's going on, is when you get stunned. When you get stunned, try to jump around into a corner or try to duck down onto the floor if nobody's around you and you just happen to get stunned. Just duck down onto the floor. And just keep on tap of triangle, make you look dead. And so that's a trick a lot of Ninja Diffuser uses, but it's also good if you get stunned. Because if you try to get up and run around, it's not going to help you. If you shoot a guy and his Marty Dome falls out his ass, just try to get around the corner real quick or just hide yourself behind the wall real quick and you'll bypass the Marty Dome and it won't kill you. It may affect you a little bit. Another very helpful tip is if you get shot and your screen is turning red, just take a break from the fighting real quick, go to the side, even if somebody's shooting at you, find a place to hide for just a couple of seconds and regain your health, and then go back out and start kicking some ass. That's what I always do, but in most of the time in my commentaries, I really don't do it because I know I'm recording and I don't know, I just want to be like some type of smartass and do some crazy stuff. So, another tip would be steady aim. With using a shotgun with grip, it's always great to use steady aim because it increases your accuracy once again. And if you, right before you shoot, you know how you press R1? If you press L1 along with R1, it'll increase your accuracy to about 99%. Because when using the grip and steady aim at the same time, your accuracy is up about 90%. Now, if you do what I do, you saw how I did it. I just like tap L1 and R1 at the same time. That increases your accuracy up to 90%. But you have to be aiming at the guy. The aiming, the crosshairs is not gonna just lock onto the guy like it does in single player or campaign mode. See right there with the grenades. There's a lot of grenade spam these days. Shipment is the worst map because it's just basically you dodging grenades the whole time. And I've seen so many people using Marty Dome and Frag Times 3 in Shipment Domination. And it's extremely annoying for the simple fact that you like to shoot people, not just dodge grenades all day. But I got a tip from my friend about a week ago, and he said that when your friend's grenade falls, you won't hear the clink sound, but when an enemy's grenade falls, you will hear the clink sound. Now, if that helps you out, if you have a turtle beach, then maybe that might help you out. But if you don't, that won't at all. So, you really can't tell the difference between your friend's grenade and your enemy's grenade. And hopefully in Modern Warfare 2, they would take out that feature. They will take out your friend's teammate's grenade indicator. Another tip that I could give to you with the shotgun is if you're going towards somebody with the shotgun and you see him about to shoot you, just try to give a little hop towards him, and that might give you the extra step you'll need. Another tip would be if you're in a place like this and somebody shoots you, just go back in for a little bit, wait for him to come, and then shoot him. If he doesn't, then go back out, try to see who you could get real quick, and run right back into that spot. That's not considered camping, that's considered playing it smart. Camping is staying at that same exact spot for the next minute or two, doing nothing but looking at the entrance with your sights up. So, also camping is considered staying in one spot with a claymore right in front of you, for instance a corner, putting a claymore right in front of you with Juggernaut M16. You guys watched my commentary, the what the fuck ending, you'll see that happens, that M16 guy, he just stood in one spot with a claymore in front of him, I jumped down and I knifed him. That's what you call a camping fail, and that's the perfect recipe to pissing a camper off, is by getting him by surprise. They will feel owned and they will feel retarded, and you will feel great. So that's a good tip. The tip when using the submachine gun is also to stay mobile, because the submachine gun is basically made for rushing. Assault rifle is made for also rushing, but it's like a different type of rushing. It's rushing, but with caution. It's like not sprinting, but like moving up, just walking forward. That's what assault rifles are basically made for. Submachine guns are made for rushing. Shotguns are made for close quarter combat. Machine guns are basically made to just stay in one spot shooting at them. But you know, that's not the case in this game. Everybody runs around with the machine gun. Sniper rifle is made for sniping, but once again, it's not the case in this game because people just jump up and down and twist and turn and no scope. But that's the game. I hope you guys enjoyed the tips. More to come. Peace.